This video is the most productive video I've had out of all three. This video, I convert a pretty so-so kind of boring village into something totally new in the beginning of a brand new villager castle. This video, I add a hospital that turns bread into babies. I also made an automatic farm, a semi-automatic farm, and a really, really stupid spider farm, along with a lot more projects. So please, hang tight, watch this full video, and just enjoy. And we are already back to the world again. I love it. Now, I have lots and lots of big projects for today. And that includes, building a wall, building a bunch of different buildings and stuff. And just, it's gonna be a lot of projects. No one big project, just everything's gonna look a little bit better. The first thing that we're gonna need, which I think is gonna be like the most necessary thing, is gonna actually be a hospital. And this hospital is going to be what keeps creating villagers. Because despite my best efforts at the wall, I don't know how many villagers I have left. And overall, this village is actually a very small village. There's only a couple houses. And my axe broke. There was not much left. More stone tools. Yippee. And I only have 10 stone. Yeah, we're really poor. Are there really only three villagers? They're having their little meeting thing right now, and there's literally three of them. And I'm just gonna get building it. It's not a complicated build at all, so I'm just gonna do it and show you guys the result. I went mining just so I could get a little bit of gold, so that I could make some powered rails and a little bit of iron, so I could make mine carts, just so I can get my villagers up to into their little breeding area. So I definitely wasted about half an hour of my life getting these things, but you know what? It's okay. So here it is. It does look a little weird. So now we just need to get a villager up into there. And there we go. Now I just need to craft a minecart. Come here, villager. Where are they? Oh, perfect. Oh, you almost made it yourself. Thank you for going in there. Now feel free to just come out. There we go. He's in my boat. Up there. There we go. Now you got to get in there. Come on. Now I send you up. Okay, we push you all the way over there. Put this just like that. And now we need to do that all again with this villager. Wait. Perfect. Now you get in there. Perfect. Look at that. Isn't this so comfy and cozy? And then once these are all broken, the villager breeder will be done. But we got this nice little staircase up. This is where I will throw food at them to make babies. But in order to make babies, I actually need to place a bunch of beds down. Now, that is not enough. So I'm gonna go to my trusty wool farm that I made last episode. Wow, yeah, that's doing pretty good. There we go, there's some solid beds. I hope that they can reach all this far. Now I'm just gonna give them some food. Now, this farm does require a lot of food, just since they need food to consensually reproduce. You can see them, they're trading the bread right now, which should make them, you know, excited. What I'm going to do is actually kind of encase this in a building so that it actually looks like a hospital. To do that, I'm going to need concrete. And for concrete, I'm going to need to go up to my house. I'm going to make two iron shovels. I'm now going to use these shovels to collect a bunch of sand and a bunch of gravel. Also collect some flowers so I can get some dye, and from there make concrete so that I can make this actually look like a hotel. And just like that, we have collected a lot. Honestly, I'm making this just up as I go. I don't even know how it's gonna look or anything. Also, as you can see, the village has sprouted to life with villagers as I've been collecting these blocks. I mean, they are everywhere. Now, I have a bunch of this white concrete powder, but I don't have any, I need the actual concrete itself. I do think we're gonna build another super simple farm over here. Wait a minute. What the heck? Somehow my camel got out. Listen, I'm sorry that I haven't been giving you as much attention as I have before. I've just been really busy, but I promise that you and me will do something soon. I'm sorry. And now I'm just gonna tower up and place all of my concrete powder going up. Wow, look at this view. I can see like my entire world up here. It almost looks like it is a sphere. Look at that. I might die, but I'm gonna risk it. Come on. Come on. Yeah, let's go. And I don't know how long it'll take because this tower goes up so far, but I'm just gonna just stay here and just mine for a while. there we go. The hospital is all done. And honestly, you know, I mean, it doesn't look the best, but knowing that it just like that I was making it up as it goes, like as I went, I'm very happy with it. And on the inside, it is very homey. Lots of windows and everything just to keep the place well lit and happy and everything. The floor is super cool. Getting this power was a little tough. This did not take only 2 stacks of concrete. This was about 5 actually. So I'm very happy I made this super simple, super cool little concrete farm. I came up with it in my mind by itself, and I'm very happy with that. I think it's really cool. I'm happy I made it. The next thing is probably going to be making something so I can just keep getting more and more food. So I'm going to make an automatic food farm. I believe that these are all the materials that I need to make this automatic food crop farm. I'm going to make 2 crop farms actually. One of them is going to be fully automatic. That's going to be the one I'm building first. And the next one is going to be a bit more manual, but probably a lot faster though. Now I'm going to be honest, I'm very happy that my place is like thriving with villagers everywhere now. However, I will admit they do get a little annoying just being everywhere all the time. Okay, that took a while, but I think I finished it. I know it looks a little funky, you know, there's this little alleyway which appears to be infested with drug deals. It's gonna take a long time before I get any profit from this, because he's gonna need to farm all of these carrots, which he's hopefully doing, replant them all, and then fill up his inventory, and then he'll start giving them to this villager, which is where I'll start getting them. So this is gonna take a while now, and that's if it works. I don't even know if it works, so this is very scary. Before I build my second farm, I'm gonna go kill a bunch of skeletons, use their bone for bone meal just to try to quicken up the process. I'm hoping to get some skeletons, some nice skeletons in here. And whoa, there's a spawner. This is actually just perfect because I could turn this into a string farm later. Now what I need is some skeletons. All right, honestly, that's gonna be good enough for now. I'm gonna now leave, hopefully without dying. And with this fancy book that I got from the dungeon, I can start my book collection. My worker over here will be busy over here. And look at that, they planted a lot more. Alrighty, so now let's just get working on that next farm. There we are, there's the farm. To fill up this entire thing with crops, I'm actually going to need to like 2.5 stacks of seeds, so this is not gonna be enough, but it will still work with what I have. How it pretty much works is that when I flip this lever like that, it'll send all this water running, and it'll just pick up all my crops. It'll push them into this water, which will push it into the hopper, which will keep it in the chest. So now I'm just gonna wait for these to grow, then I'll harvest these ones, and I'll slowly be able to fill up this whole thing. And then once I fill up this whole thing, then, whoopsie, I need to figure out a better way to actually, maybe if I put my ladders up here. There we go. So there's my one form of food. I'll be able to constantly be working on that. And it's close enough to my house that it should be growing even when I'm in my house and in the village. So that's one form where I can manually collect wheat so I can make it into bread and give it to them. And I'll also have this farm, which as you can see, he is slowly filling it up. And once it's completely full, then I should have a solid, solid constant supply of carrots. My original plan was to build a big wall around this village this episode, but since I found that spider spawner from earlier, I'm thinking that my next project is going to be able to make that an official like spawner. But right now I'm going to go get the materials I need to make that spider spawner an automatic string machine. Alrighty, things are looking pretty good. My hotbar is filled with the items that I need, almost all the items that I need. I still need 3 more hoppers, but I'm all out of iron. I also wanna just check in, see how this farm is doing. It looks like it's getting pretty close. I'm not gonna do it yet, but it does look like it's getting close. Now I wanna go check the automatic farm. And I have been AFKing for a little bit. Oh yeah, look at that. And I will give this straight to them. That should be lots of food. They should be feeling very, very excited really soon. We should have a new baby. Hey, and we got a new kid. Now, hopefully he learns that he can actually walk and be free out here. Before I leave, I am gonna check out my wool farm, which, oh man, 4.5 stacks. There we go. That's some more beds down, and I've got almost an entire chest full of beds too. So I'm not gonna add those yet just because if I was to add all of those beds, like it would literally be beds everywhere. But we have no shortage of beds. First thing we're gonna need to do is just light up for now this entire place. Now you can already see like there's no more mobs in here and it was like a full-on army. So now I can get working on this. And the spider spawner is completely done. Wah! No! It's not completely done. Okay, now it is done, and it is actually done. And it is one of the ugliest builds I've done in my life. Now, could I have, you know, went out and collected terracotta for like the billionth time and made actually clean layers and stuff? Yes, but that seems like a lot of work. And here are all your and your skeleton. But other than the skeleton, here are all your spiders and stuff. Now, it does appear that they like to climb up. Yeah. So I don't really know how to fix that. I also did go out and collect a bunch of iron, and I even found this precious diamond right there. Oh, it's beautiful. Oh my goodness. First diamond in this world yet. So we'll have to do something fancy with that. I think this is gonna work. Honestly, my Minecraft logic is pretty slim. I believe if we put signs around that they won't be able to climb. The only reason I'm making this stupid ass spawner is because I had the actual spawner itself. But right now, I'm not thinking that was worth it. Closest edge about it. Come on. Please tell me they can't climb anymore. I don't think they can. Wait, I can't tell. What the hell? How? No way, I just wasted all that damage and everything and they can still climb. Actually, okay, new plan. I don't know if this plan will work either, but apparently soul sand, they can't climb on soul sand either. So I'm gonna go see if I can find some soul sand and then I'll fix the farm from there. Well, you would never believe it. Minecraft Bedrock Edition sucks. I was going through my portal, right? Minding my own business. And the second I walked through, there's a creeper and I blew up and died. That's why I have no levels, right? And so then I walk through again, like, you know, oh, that's so annoying. And it spawns me a new portal because the creeper blew up that portal. And I spawn to this one and the creeper blows up again. Now I have two empty frames and no flint and steel. But before I figure out how to get back, I'm gonna go find this stupid soul sand. Well, there's my suicide. And it didn't even look like there was soul sand there. Well, you know what we're gonna do then is that... Oh, I lost my diamond! No! No moving for me. Well, I guess this is what happens when you play Minecraft Bedrock 1.2 Experimental. Alrighty, we're back and we're able to move. So I'll give you guys a quick little tour. We've got this super, super complicated but cool concrete... concrete powder into concrete maker. I also made this hospital. You can actually turn food into babies. I have my automatic carrot farm, which he's not working right now because he's sleepy. Now he should be working away. I'm not sure where he got the seed, but you know what? Good for him. That's an automatic farm. I also have a semi-automatic farm here. You know, just for lack of content, I'm just gonna run it. Flip the lever. You don't really have a good view, but here comes the wave. And it goes and just pushes it all into there. And there we are now. And we went from at the beginning a stack and five to now two stacks and eight. There we are, all seeds planted. We just need this many more seeds and we'll have it all planted and then we'll be getting a bunch. And then last and definitely least, I did make my automatic spider farm, which is, it's the ugliest farm. It's probably the least helpful farm. All right, but that is gonna be the end of this video. This was overall, even though this, with the slight disappointment of the spider spawner, this was a very, very successful video. That's that video. Thank you guys for watching. And for those of you who stayed till the end and listen to me rant like right now. And yeah, have a good one, you guys. See you next video.